got our new 2024 Rockwood Geo Pro G15TB with the twin beds. Just got it in day before yesterday. First thing I did was come out here with my heat gun and the goof off and took off all those warning stickers. They were everywhere. And it's, you know, stupid warning stickers, like things you should know, like don't touch hot stuff, and if you weigh 900 pounds, don't try to climb up on the roof, you know. And the labels that were saying, this is your black and gray tank drain point. You know, I can see it's a drain point. I don't need a sticker. So I took that off. My outside shower, 30 amp outlet. I left those labels just because, so when I need to winterize, I don't have to try to remember. Fresh water fill, water heater. Got frameless windows. You saw my reflection in there. Frameless windows on the back. I already installed my backup camera, my wireless backup camera. Then you got your storage access from the back. And the camper comes with the griddle that you see right there, a little table that attaches outside. I'll show you in a second. And then, of course, you get a power cord. You get a spatula. And a water hose to use with your outside shower point. And you get some kind of metal bar for like a towel bar. You get a toilet paper roll thing, but it's not installed for some reason. And you get one free water filter. See that? And then that's a connector for a sewer hose. Which, if you need it, you need it. That's the brackets to mount that towel bar thing and the paper towel holder. You get two manual cranks. The little bitty one, I'm not sure what it's for. This one right here is for the leveling of the stabilizer jacks, rather, and for raising and lowering the spare tire, which is stored underneath. Now, of course, you got your ladder going up to the roof. I'm not going to go up there. I'll tell you what's up there. You got air conditioner. You have a 200 watt solar panel. You have your TV antenna, your WineGuard TV antenna, and your max fan. And then on your back, you got a bumper, but it's recessed under there. You do have a hitch so you can store something. I think there's a 300 pound limit. And then I'll let you look under here. Ugh. Oh, the ground's still wet. That is Alice Cooper, our cat. And you can see the stabilizers. They have the little V-shaped thing there that, so if you do happen to bottom out on something, it'll hit those instead of hitting the camper. Your freshwater drain point, your freshwater tank, which is 31 gallons. And the other end of your quick drops stabilizer, that's your propane access point for the little griddle. Are you comfortable under there, Alice Cooper? The reason the cat is named Alice Cooper is because when we got it, it was teeny, and at first glance we thought it was a girl. The grandkids named it Alice. When it got older, we found out it was a boy. So we just, rather than change her name, we just added Cooper on it, since Alice Cooper's a man. There you go, frameless window on that side, outdoor speaker, your storage access. This little door here is little. You can see my hand. I have normal sized man hands, and you can see just how small this door is. The griddle will fit in and out of there, and the little shelf will sideways. And then this right here is the little bar that that griddle and table mount to. Of course, your Chinese off-road tire. You have 120 volt, your heater exhaust, the little flip-up steps, which some people love them, some people hate them. I don't really care, to be honest. Ooh, we'll look under here, and there's your spare, and there's your little thing so you can crank the spare up and down. Sewer hose storage if you so choose to use it, can be opened from either end. And then we come over here, and you can see your other stabilizer jack, your battery box, 220-pound propane tanks, electric tongue jack. Your tongue jack comes with that little foot or a wheel. I prefer the foot. And then I'll try to show you under here if I can. You can see there's your gray tank right there, which I'm going to swap that gray tank out because it's only 12 gallons. And you can't take much of a shower more than once or twice with a 12-gallon tank. I'll figure something out. Your door has a friction hinge, so wherever you put it, it'll stay. One of the first things I did was swap out the lock so I could have a keyless one. Then you got power awning. We'll step inside here. Ooh, I'll squat down here and show you the control panel. Believe it or not, this is Bluetooth and you can control most things from your phone. Like you can open the on and turn the water heater on and things like that from your phone. That's a little light down there, USB port, which is like a dumb place to put it, but there it is. And then you step in, you walk in, and I guess I'll turn the light on. Oh, I don't remember which button it is. Hang on a second. Interior. There we go, interior light. And then you got all of your overhead storage, doors covered with doors, with just little nets right there. And then it's a little more storage over here. You got your pull down shades. These are kind of chintzy, but it is what it is. And they're supposedly a blackout, so they reduce the light. You have this window's open, which is also an exit. So I can't imagine that you wouldn't just jump out right there, which is 4 feet away. But hey, to each his own. Your back window, it opens as well. And then this side window opens as well. And then you have a 12-volt TV, a Connex brand. Piece of crap, but it is what it is. There is Rosie, one of our miniature schnauzers. And then, of course, we bought this camper specifically because of the two twin beds. You know, we're older, we don't have to sleep touching each other. It's actually a little better. And then, if you're more than, I'm 6 feet tall and I fit. They're 74-inch beds and I'm 72 inches, so it's a little tight, but you know, you can sleep sideways if you wanted to. You know, you take the two tabletops and put them on top of those black things right there, and it makes a king size bed, I guess, and you sleep sideways, then you got plenty of room. It came with this lagoon style table stand. That is not a lagoon brand, it is something else, but it came with that one. And I'm gonna buy another one because, you know, the tabletop sections are very small. It's only room for one laptop. And so I will buy another stand like that to mount on this side, and then use that tabletop for it. Underneath this side over here, you have your water pump and your water heater and a bunch of hoses and electrical whatnots. And then down here on this side, you have access to your outside storage from right there. Sorry about my finger. There you got a GFCI outlet. And then another one over here. That's your on-off switch for your refrigerator. That is the, I don't know why that won't focus. Apologize for that. That is the PWM charge controller that came with it. I've already ordered the new Victron MPPT charge controller to replace that one. That is your thermostat for controlling the heat and air. You have two drawers. That bottom one won't stay shut when you travel. So I'm going to have to figure that out. And then you got your fridge. fridge has this little travel lock, which is handy. Good size freezer. It's not, you know, gigantic, but good grief. What do you need? And then refrigerator. Easy dial there for changing your settings. I mean, plenty of room for the basics. You know, again, if you need a bigger fridge for that, then you probably need a bigger camper than this. Just saying. Air conditioner up top. Of course, it is not ducted because there ain't room. You can got your safety stuff there, your smoke detector, and that's where you can get extend. That's a Wi-Fi extender. I'm not sure how to use it yet. I'm gonna have to scan that barcode and see what the deal is. And then you have a wet bath, which the wife absolutely hates. She hates the idea of it, that you poop in the shower. But hey, go to the bathhouse. You have a waterproof storage area back there, so you can keep toilet paper and whatnot in there. And that's a plastic toilet. It's not even a fancy porcelain one. It has a water miser, so while you're waiting, when you're running the water, waiting for the hot water to get to you, it redirects that cold water back to the holding tank, so you don't waste it just going down the drain, which is kind of handy. And then you have a little light and a little fan, exhaust fan in there.
Did you already order you another tank?
Over the little kitchen area, you have two storage shelves. The 2024 models added that second shelf right there on the bottom. And then you have your little sink with this little gizmo wheels up out of the way. It rolls. Three burner stove. I don't know why they would put that gigantic stove top there, cooktop there, but a little skinny two burner would have been perfect. This right here is a little power outlet. You have to be connected to shore power for this to work, even the USBs. down here, you have an inverter which you can turn on, and every outlet that's in the camper like this runs through the inverter. So if you turn that on, you know, you'll have electricity in every outlet. You can't run the air conditioner or the microwave off the inverter, but you can anything else. Bottle opener. I guess they just thought that was gonna be nifty. A little sponge drawer. You got a little cabinet here. It came with that little silverware tray. And then you got some little drawers down here that are not very deep at all. And this one over here is the same way. You have a convection microwave since there is no oven. Fire extinguisher, which we all know that the fire extinguisher is the little white thing that you run past if the camper catches on fire. And there you have your max fan. So you got a quality fan in here. It's not one of them little chintzy ones. So overall, it's pretty cool. We like it. Like I said, we just got it, hadn't camped in it yet. Our current camper, which we just sold, is see it way out there. That is a 2022 Grand Design Transcend Explorer 221RB. Let's see if I can zoom in a little bit, let y'all see a little better. But that one there is 27 feet long, and it has a slide out. And I hate slide outs. It's not if the slide out ever breaks. It's no, it's not when. Well, it's if and when. Anyway, here's the wife with a hair in her face. But yeah, we sold that one because it doesn't fit in the state parks very well. Took it to a trip to Texas and stayed at Tyler State Park, and I like not a fit. I had like 2 inches to spare when once I let the slide out. And I was like, yeah, that's too aggravating. So I decided to get something that's shorter. That, you know, my truck's 2500, it'll tow any of it, but that's it. There you can see the Max Air fan cover up there, low profile air conditioning unit. And then I don't know if you can see the solar panel. Yeah, you can right there. Like I said, I ordered a new charge controller. I also ordered an additional solar panel. I think the one I got was 180 watts because of the size. You only have like 26 inches between the air conditioner and the edge of the camper. So when you put a solar panel up there, you can no longer walk on that side. And so to put a solar panel on the other side, I found one that was 24 inches. So that would leave just enough room to squeak your foot through there to get to the other side, to get to the front, if you needed to. Or you could just put a ladder up there and climb up there that way. But I think it looks good without all them warning stickers, because my goodness, they were everywhere. It took me an hour to get all them stupid things off. But that's it. 2024 Geo Pro G15TB. As you can see on the back here, we bought it at Camping World. I don't really care for Camping World. Generally don't have good experiences with them. And I didn't have a good experience with them this time. I called. I told them how much I would pay for this camper. They told me no at first. And then after a little back and forth, they agreed to my price. And then I was gonna go on a Sunday and put about half down and then finance the other half. And they tried to jack the price on me by adding in some sort of camping package and a big dock fee and all that. And I was like, no. And I ended up having to get the general manager of the Anniston, Alabama location involved. And once he got involved, it went smoothly. He agreed to the out-the-door price, which I paid $21,276.06 out the door for this camper, which I think was a good deal. I would have bought it somewhere else had they not matched the price, but they were the closest dealer to me. And so I went ahead and bought it from them. And of course, when you buy from Camping World, you get a free year of roadside and a free year of Good Sam membership and a free year of travel assist from Good Sam. And you know, there's a few perks. They're not enough to make me want to shop with them, but you know, is what it is. But I'm glad to have it. We're excited to have it. Getting it ready. All of the extra stuff I ordered should be here Wednesday and Thursday. And I'll get that installed. And of course, I'll document that for you. And if you got any questions, hey, feel free to hit me up in the comments. And you can also go to our website, which we've had for, mercy, since 2009, maybe, rvroadtrip.us. And you can see all our camping adventures, all the campers we've had over the years, and all the places we've been, and things we've done, and sights we've seen. All righty, y'all take care.